Hey Frank, welcome to Lakeshore RV and congratulations on your new Montana High Country 331 rear living fifth wheel. Let's go ahead and take a look at your beautiful new camper and learn all about it. Up front, you've got a molded fiberglass front cap with a cutaway on the edges to make tight turning easier, LED lights built in, a mirror to look down into the bed of the truck to hook up to your Road Armor pin box. This is going to tilt and pivot back and forth, take away some of the herky jerky as you're towing down the road. Inside the service compartment here, let's get a little light on here for you. A little motion sensor couldn't see me. We're going to have on this side a blue coil hose for your quick connect for your hot and cold water shower. I'll show you where that goes in a minute. Your 50 amp service cable. On this side, we're going to have your 30 amp controller. You're going to have a disconnect for your solar panels, your inverter for your fridge, disconnect for your battery, and an on and off switch for your inverter. So when you want to close this all down, all of these switches need to be turned off. We've got some LED lights outside. And this is your auto leveling system by Lippert. And turn it on here, you'll be able to go through and level off your camper. I've got a really cool video that shows you how to use it and a little reminder sheet inside the propane door. You have two 30 pound propane tanks all filled up and ready to go. Nice huge pass-through storage. It is heated. More LED light sensors there for us. You're gonna have your hot and cold water shower. That's where that connection hose would attach. Winterization. Quick connect for cable and satellite. Connection for your fresh water. You're going to be able to take it and put it on normal flow, which would be for city water, or to fill your onboard holding tank and your black tank sewage flush. So when you go to pull your gray valve and black valve to dump out those holding tanks, you would also be able to have that valve open and run fresh water through and help clean it out. Low point drain valves for your hot and cold water. Down underneath, you're going to have a little PVC tube. That is for your sewer hose to hide that stinky slinky. And then we have a let off for your hot, or for your gray and black tanks. And you're going to have one more gray tank pull valve right there. That would be for your kitchen. Two beautiful slide outs on this side. Coming around back, you have your hookup for your 50 amp service cable. 2-inch receiver hitch with a 4-way flat wiring harness if you want a tandem tow someday. Ladder to access your serviceable walkable roof. You are prepped and readied for a backup or an observation camera. Power awning with the LED lights underneath. And a second power awning with LED lights underneath. Magnets are going to hold these. The side pass-through storage door, there is a little lock latch that you do need to release for the door to be able to slam closed. We have your sewer hose and electrical adapters in here, hookup for power, cable, and satellite, and then also LED lighting. And then this compartment has your second 30-pound propane tank. Let's go inside and take a look at the rest of your 331 RL. All right, when you walk in, you're going to have a central vacuum system. Open it up, put the hose in, and turn it on. Fuse panel and breaker box down below. Little cubby storage. And just above that, we have the business end of the camper. So we've got a readout for the current voltage that is available to you. On and off for the ceiling fan. You'll be able to track your battery level, your tank levels, to see if it's time to dump or fill your fresh water. We have a water pump, gas and electric heating elements. Turn off some of these bright blue lights, maybe make it a little easier to see for you. Then we're going to have those overall LED lights, fresh tank, black and gray tank, 12-volt blankets if you're camping in the cold. And then the outside lighting.
Each slide out has its own button, and each awning has its own as well. Stepping down below, we're going to find some additional LED lights, some accents, and then you're going to have your thermostat for your furnace and your rear AC. Just hold and twist around to set the temperature and which setting you want. This max air vent is for right there. Nice big fan in the kitchen where we need it. 18 cubic foot residential refrigerator. There is that little locking latch. It just screws on, helps keep those doors closed while you're traveling down the road. Huge center island with extension. You do have solid surface countertops and covers. Nice big stainless steel sink. There is a spot down below here, right there, to hide your sink covers if you need to while you're traveling. LED lighting underneath the island as well. And there is a switch down at the end. Nice big pantry with motion sensor LEDs. Again, nice residential 30-inch microwave. Three burner cooktop by Furrion. Just choose which burner or oven you want on, and it has the ignite on. They even thought to put a little magnet bar to hold knives and pot holders or anything else you would like. You have electric fireplace set up. You can turn that on, go through, change the flame settings. It has a fan, temperature, and timer on it. JBL sound system and 50-inch TV. Along the rear, you have a tri-fold sleeper sofa. This will open up to a queen-size bed. So that's the sheets you need to buy if you need. USB ports and utility outlets on both sides of your sofa. We do have power on your theater seating. Cup holders, great place to lose the remote control, of course. Along the wall, you have a dimmer switch for the LED lights above your recliners. And then four chair, table, and dinette. There are some straps around the bottom to wrangle the chairs in place so they don't go anywhere while you're traveling down the road. We'll have those secured before they leave. Pull down, roll up shades. Love the pantry and cabinetry in this camper. And there is some more motion sensor LEDs on the stairwell. Huge double sink bathroom. We do have another fan vent in here as well. Foot flush porcelain toilet. You have a beautiful three panel glass shower door. Please make sure it is latched before you hit the road, or you will have a 3,000 piece shower door. Nice big linen closet hiding behind the magnet stop closed door. Real quick, so pretty. And we have your second AC here in your master bedroom with the king-size bed. Same thermostat as we saw before. USB ports, power outlets, and little nightstands on both sides of the bed. Down below, we have your accessories and hoses for your central vacuum system. Montana's have a cool mattress that's soft and firm, so flip it over to which side you prefer. Washer dryer prep is in your main closet, and then you do have a mirrored wardrobe closet. Tons of storage. This camper is definitely beautiful and made to be lived in. I look forward to talking with you soon, answering any more questions you might have on your new Montana High Country today or down the road. If you need me, give me a call, April Welch at Lakeshore RV Center. Congratulations, Frank.